Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss about the types of well equipments. That is the drilling components that are used in a well. That is used in a drilling process. Okay. In this video I will be giving you the overall idea of how drilling is going on. Okay. And we will be going through all the vocabulary and the terms that are used in the oil and gas industry. Okay. Basically majority of the students know all the equipment such as crown block, traveling block, drill bits, such type of things. Okay, while studying those only, I will be teaching you some of the terms that are generally used in oil and gas industry, such as a dog house, cellar, catwalk, walkways, such type of things. Okay, I will be going one by one. Okay, firstly, let us go into it. See, this is a drilling rig. Basically, how do you define drilling rig is defined as, the equipment which holds all the other equipment that are used in a drilling process. Okay, so this is a drilling rig. Basically drilling rig has the equipment such as derricks or masts or crown blocks, traveling block. These drilling rig holds all the equipments. Okay, firstly let us see the types of equipment that are present. So basically in a drilling rig, a crown block will be present. This is the crown block. Next, derrick or mast. Okay, firstly that you have to remember is derrick is term used for conventional rigs. Okay, that are built in that particular area. Masts are is a term used for mobile rigs. Okay, remember this, derrick and mast. Derrick is used for conventional rigs. Mast is used for mobile rigs. Okay, if you can see here, this is the derrick. Okay, in mobile case it is mast. Okay, we'll be going through monkey board. Okay, monkey board is an equipment where a driller will be present, and he will be from the monkey board, a particular driller or a drilling personnel will be using it to store the drill pipe while tripping out operations is going on. Okay, we'll be studying that in detail. The other term is drilling lines. The next one is traveling block. The traveling block is the block which is moving up and down in the drilling rig. Okay, these are stands, swivel. Okay, let's go one by one. Firstly, let's come to the topmost part. The first term is the crown block. Okay, basically crown block will be the topmost part present in drilling rig. Okay, if you can see here, the one is the crown block. Okay, before going into all the components, let me show you a video and try to explain all the components in a single video. Okay, right now I'll be showing you a video which contains all the equipments, so you have to remember it. Okay, see, basically before drilling, what they will do is they will bring all the equipment to the rig site using trucks. Okay, this is a mobile rig, and all the equipment required for the drilling will be brought through trucks. Okay, right now what we are doing is we are building a cantilevered rig. Okay, in the previous class I have taught you what are different types of rigs that are present. Those are cantilevered, telescopic, bootstrap and jackknife. Okay, right now the type of rig that is used here is the cantilevered. Okay, if you can see here, this is how a cantilever rig is installed. Okay, basically it will be installed through drawworks that are present in the well rig, on the well rig. Okay, this is how the cantilever rig is present. If I pause the video, see. Okay, wait a minute. Once it is installed, it will be layered, means lifted to the upward. Okay, now let us stop the video. Wait a minute. Okay. See, right now, wait a minute, let me see. See, I will be teaching you, means I will be showing you the types of equipment. Okay, if you can see in the, see the arrow, the arrow that is showing the red house is known as dog house. Okay, any room that is present on the rig floor is known as dog house. Okay, and if you can see the pointer that is showing the drawworks, those are drawworks. Okay, and if you can see these four pillars that are present below the rig floor, see, if you can see the four pillars, one, this is one, this is two, this is three, and the other one is present on the back side. Okay, in between the four pillars there is a space present in it. Okay, those space is called cellar. Okay, firstly let us go one by one. See, you have to remember this, guys. One is the dog house. Dog house is a room, present on the rig floor, okay. Any room that is present on the rig floor is called a dog house. Basically a dog house is a place where some equipments can be stored or drilling activities related activity will be going on there. Okay, basically a driller will be present there. Okay, the next one is, drawworks. Basically, I think everybody know what a drawworks is. It is used to lift the equipment. That is, all the drilling line will be wound up in the drawworks, and by controlling the amount of drilling line, he can lift the equipment. Okay, lift, and it contains all the equipment. It contains all the drilling line inside it. Drilling lines in it. Okay, let's go step by step again. Okay, if you can see here, the area or the room that is present below the rig floor is called cellar. So right now this cellar, you have to remember these terms, that is doghouse, cellar, drawworks, and the difference between derrick and mast. Okay, cellar, it is the space available below the rig floor. Okay, it is the space available below the rig floor. If you can see the animation here, this is the space that is available below the rig floor, so that is called a cellar. Okay, and if you can see here, from ground to the rig floor there is a stairs present with handrails. Okay, if see the pointer. Okay, there is a stairs present which are used to bring the personnel from ground level to the rig floor. That is called walkways. These are the terms that are used in oil and gas industry, guys. So remember this. So walkways are stairs. Not only stairs, anything that connects, means if there is a way from the ground to the rig floor that is like this through stairs, it is called walkways. Stairs that connects rig floor and ground floor. Okay, these are some of the vocabulary that we used in the oil and gas industry. Okay, so try to remember them. Okay, yes, okay, let's go step by step. Yes, okay, let's pause it here. See, if you can see here, on the top of the derrick, okay, if you, this handrail is there, red color handrail and white color fingers. Okay, actually that is this 13, that is the monkey board. by presenting on the monkey board, what a particular driller can do is, he can take this drill pipe and place it on the finger boards. Okay, this is called monkey board, or it is also called wait a minute. Yes, yes, wait a minute. Yeah, it is also called racking board. Not only monkey, the other name for monkey board is the racking board. Okay, let's write it. Monkey board. See, I will explain it to you clearly. Or it is also known as raking board. Okay. A drilling personnel will be present on it while tripping or running in go while tripping or running in operations. Okay, present on it during tripping or running in operation. Basically what he will be doing is, I will show you a video so you can understand it. See, basically, let me show it to you what he will be doing. See, right now, this is the pause. See, a drilling personnel is present on the monkey board, okay? And these fingers, or which is used to store the drill pipe, is called finger boards, okay? The place where he is standing is called monkey board. The fingers that is used to store the drill pipe is called finger board. Okay, the other name for monkey board is the racking board. Okay, if you can see the video, see, during the tripping out operation, a drilling personnel is present on the monkey board. Okay, what he's doing is, once a drill pipe is brought to the surface, he will be storing them. Okay, he will be storing them on the finger board. Okay, right now if you can see, while he is catching it, the personnel that is present on the rig, that is on the rig, will break the connection between this drill pipe and the drill pipe present inside the hole. Okay, and this drilling personnel that is present on the monkey board, he will be storing this drill pipe, that is tripped out drill pipe inside the finger board. If you can see there, yes, he is storing it in the finger board. Okay, okay, let's go to the next one. This is the main things about related to monkey board and raking board, that is even the finger board. If you can see the pointer, these white lines are finger board. Those are used to store the drill pipes during tripping out or running in operations. Okay, let's go. If you can see the video, 10 minute. Yes. Okay, the red one is the doghouse, and this white one, this yellow one is called traveling block. Okay. Let's go still. Yes, okay, this is somewhat important. Okay, if you can see here, this is the pointer that is showing here is the pipe ramp. This is called pipe ramp. Okay, it is somewhat at an angle to the drilling pipe. Okay, and this is called catwalk. Okay, see the pointer, this is called catwalk, this is called pipe ramp. And the first, before starting of the drilling, the drill pipes will be stored here. Okay, this is called pipe. Wait a minute, its name is yes, pipe storage. Means they used to store all the pipes on it. Okay, so one thing that you have to remember is, this is the pipe ramp. See the pointer, this is the pipe ramp, these are catwalk and this is pipe storage. Okay, yes, the other name for pipe storage is pipe racks. Okay, so let's write. See, basically, initially, pipes will be on pipes, that is, drill pipes will be on pipe rack. Pipe rack. From there, they will go to catwalk. Catwalk is the present horizontally. Okay. From there, it will go to pipe ramp. Pipe ramp is the one that is present. Pipe ramp. These are all the terms that are used in oil and gas industry, guys. So if you can see the video, see, these are all the mud pumps that are used in oil and gas industry. So that is used in drilling process. Okay. Yes, if you can see how it is going from pipe ramp, see, from pipe racks it is going on to the catwalk. Okay, this is an advanced model. What is happening, the catwalk is going to the pipe ramp. Generally, what will be happening is, from the pipe ramp, a drilling line will be present and it will pull the drill pipe onto the pipe ramp. From there, it will be going into the mouse hole. Okay, this is an advanced model, so try to understand it. Okay, from the pipe ramp, a drilling line will be attached to the drill pipe that will be present on the catwalk. Okay, and from using the drilling line, these drill pipe will be pulled to the pipe ramp. From there, it will be transferring it to another hole, which is used to store drill pipes. Those are mouse hole. Okay, we'll be studying about that in the next PPTs, but for now understand it. Okay, basically this drill pipe will come to the pipe ramp. From there, it will go to the, if you can see this hole beside the rotary table. This is the rotary table. This yellow one is the rotary table and the red one is the rotary bushing, and this white small hole that is present beside the rotary table is the mouse hole, which is used to store the next joint of the drill pipe. Okay, let's go. Yes, if you can see here, this is a very, very new equipment. Okay, basically, this is called Kelly spinner. This is called a Kelly spinner. The Kelly spinner is an equipment which is used to make or break the connections. Okay, we will be going through every equipment one by one. Okay, but for now, let's have an overall idea. What are the types of equipments? Okay, this is a Kelly spinner which is used to make or break the connections between different drill pipes. Okay, this is a Kelly spinner. Yes, drill pipe is rotating. Okay, and the red ones, if you can see here, this red equipment is called elevators. Okay, these are called elevators. What we'll be doing with elevators is, we will be lifting different types of pipes to the derrick. Okay, suppose if you are running in casing, how is casing lifted onto the well is, it is lifted using elevators. Okay, this red color equipment is called elevator. See the pointer. Okay. See, remember all the terms and vocabulary that is used. Okay, see, if you can see here, right now it is enclosed. Those enclosed area is called cellar. This, see the pointer, this is pipe ramp. Okay, if you can see here, these are all the things, pipes that are stored on the fingerboard. Okay. the red color one is called dog house. Yes, let's go one by one. Yes, this is the part of the video I want to show you. Okay, let's go to the real life situations and what are the equipments that is used there. Okay, but before going to the real life, let us first go through all the equipment. Okay, after that I will be explaining all the processes that different equipment have. Okay, let's go. See, okay, first let's go to the equipment. See, first one is the crown block, which will be present on top of it. Okay, on the very top of the drilling rig, crown block will be present, and crown block will be having sheaves which will be attached to the traveling block using drilling line. Okay, so this is the crown block. If you come to the 24, this is very, very important. This is crown block. This is very, very important. The 24 is very important. Basically, majority of students don't know that is called hoist line. Okay, see, traveling block, that is traveling block, then the elevators attached to the traveling block generally lift the equipment that are required for the well. Okay, the hoist line lift the equipment, if you can see here, lift the equipment from the ground onto the rig floor. Okay, suppose if you want to install draw works on the top of the rig floor, it is brought up from the ground using the hoist line. Okay, basically consider, you can think it of it as a crane. Okay, while building and building apartment or anything, a crane will be present to bring all the equipment to the surface of the apartment. Okay, that is the same thing that the hoist line do on a drilling rig. Okay, to bring the equipment from the ground to the rig floor, we use the hoist line. Okay, write this one. See, I am giving the definition in very, very, very basic terms. Okay, so you can understand. So hoist lines, it is used to bring the equipment, to bring any equipment from ground to the rig floor. Okay, to the rig floor. Okay, let's go to the next one. 13 is the monkey board or racking board. Okay, beside monkey board, finger board will be present, which is used to store pipes, drill pipes, during tripping out or running in operations. Okay, if you can see 15 is called derrick. Okay, basically derrick is a term used for conventional rigs or mast for mobile rigs. Okay, and 25 is drilling line. Okay, 16 is traveling block is a block which travels on in the drilling rig. Okay, basically a traveling block will have grooves which is attached to the crown block using the drilling line. Okay, if you go down, yeah, this is a top drive. Right now here they are using top drive, so you don't have to know the equipment. Okay, yes, the three is called dog house. Okay, and if you can see the 18 part is important. Basically 18 is draw works. If you can see here, a particular cylindrical equipment is attached to the draw works, that is called cat head. Okay, that is very, very, very important. Okay, basically to make or break connections between Kelly and the next drill pipe, we use cat head and spinning chain. Okay, let me go to the next term, that is cat head and spinning chain. Okay, let me explain this to you. See, basically rotatable will be present. So to make or break connections, what we'll be doing is, we'll be using tongs. Tongs are the equipments like screws, so it will catch on to it to make the connections between Kelly and drill pipe. Okay, if it best I will show you a video, so it is easy for you to understand.
Okay.
If you can see the video. Okay, if you can see the video, see right now what they are doing is they are drilling. Okay, they are using rotary table to rotate the kelly. This is the kelly that is attached to it. Okay. Yes. See, right now if you can see beside the kelly there is, see the arrow, there is a next drill pipe present inside a particular hole. This particular hole is called mouse hole. Okay, mouse hole. That is used to store the next joint of the drill pipe. Next joint of the drill pipe. Okay. See the process that is involved. The equipment. If you can see this, the red equipment that this person, this drilling person is carrying is the tongs. Okay. On the tongs. If you can see here, the chain attached to the bottom of the next drill pipe is called spinning chain. Okay. I will explain it to you what is the spinning chain and how it works. Okay. See, this N4 is called draw works. Okay, right now that is called draw works, and slips, the man that right now that is installed is the slips. Okay, they are used for to keep the drill pipe in place. Okay, slips are used to keep the drill pipe in place. Okay, if you can see right now he is using tongs. And the rotary table to break the connection between the kelly and the drill pipe. Okay. If you can see right now, the kelly is being attached to the next drill pipe that is present inside the mouse hole. Okay. He is attaching the kelly to the next drill pipe that is present inside the mouse hole. If you can see, he is using both the tongs to catch it. Okay, right now how do they make a connection between the kelly and the next drill pipe. Okay, basically what he will be using, he will be using the spinning chain. And wait a minute. See, he is using the spinning chain. If you can see beside the draw works, there will be a cat head which rotates the spinning chain. Okay, let me explain it to you in detail. See, basically consider this is the draw works. Okay, and this is the drilling line that is present inside the draw work. Okay, beside the draw work there will be a cat head. Okay, which rotates with the draw works. Okay, with the draw works. See, draw works will be rotated like this to wound the drill pipe or drill chain. Okay, to round the drill chain or the drilling line, it will be rotated. Okay, the rotation will be similar to here also. This is called cat head. A chain will be attached to the cat head. Okay, this chain is called spinning chain. By rotation of the cat head, if you can see the video, this cat head and the spinning chain, see the arrow, this is the spinning chain that is attached to the drill pipe. Using the cat head rotation and this particular chain, the connection is being made between the kelly and the next drill pipe. Okay, so you can write down this one. Cat head and chaining and spinning chain, they are used to make or break the connections between the tubulars. Okay, remember this, the cat head and the spinning chain. So okay, let's continue. See, through spinning chain he has made the connection. He made a connection between the drill pipe, kelly and the drill pipe. Through the mouse hole it is being lifted up. These red color equipments are called tongs. Through tongs and the rotary table he will be making the connection between the drill pipe present in the mouse hole and the next drill pipe. Okay, see, right now he is also using the spinning chain. Okay, to effectively make a connection, right now he is also using the spinning chain. Okay, if you can see here, yes, he is using one tong, a spinning chain to make the connection. Okay, right now he is removing the slips. Right now he is removing the slips. These are the slips that are used to hold the drill pipe in place. Okay, hold the drill pipe in place. So basically that is cat head and Kelly spinner. Sorry, cat head and spinning chain. Okay, let's go to the next components. And the 5 is drill pipe, the 6 is drill bit. Okay, and yes, if you go down still, the 11 is called walkways because the 11 is walkways. Okay, and the 4th is, yes, here the 4 is bell nipple. Remember this bell nipple. A bell nipple is an equipment which change the flow rate from straight to the horizontal direction. Okay, basically it will be diverting the flow. A bell nipple is used to divert the flow from outside annulus of the weld to the shale shaker. Okay, from bell nipple, the bell nipple will divert the flow from the annulus of the bore hole to the shale shaker. Okay, let me draw a diagram so you can understand. These are some terms that are not, that we don't study regularly. Okay, see, below the, consider this is the blowout preventer. From the blowout preventer, a drill pipe will be present, and through the annulus water will be coming, and above the blowout preventer a bell nipple will be present. This is called bell nipple, and bell nipple will divert the flow from vertical to the horizontal to the shale shakers. Okay, so write down this one, bell nipple diverts the flow from vertical to the horizontal. Okay, let's go to the next. Okay, and if you can say below this, all the space that is present is the cellar. Okay, all the space present inside below the rig floor is called cellar. Okay, and the 24 is called manual, which is used to control the amount of fluid that is going inside the wellbore. Okay, the 8 is called shale shakers. They remove the big cuttings that is present inside the drilling fluid. The 9 is called desanders or desilters, such type of things, the small things. Okay, and here the 10 is the pipe rack. Pipe rack can be present anywhere, not only beside the catwalk, it can be present anywhere. Okay, here the 20 is the mud pit. Here 20 is the mud pit. These are something that you have to remember. Okay, and if you go here, yes, the 14 are reserve, the 14, 17 are the reserve pits which holds all the drilling fluid inside it. Okay, those drilling fluids inside it. Okay, let's these are some of the equipments generally you should know. Okay, that is used in drilling rigs. Okay, apart from these, there are several equipments such as IC engines, internal combustion engines. Okay, inside the combustion engines, the 22 is water, that is water tank, such type of things. Okay, basically all the other things are very, very small. Okay, let's go one by one again. See, the first one is crown block. It will be present on top of the drilling rig. Okay. Hoist line. As I have already told you, a structural framework erected near the top of the drilling rig for lifting material. Okay. This is used to lift the material from ground to the rig floor. If you can see here, this is the hoist line. Next is the drilling line. It is basically a rope which is used between draw works, a crown block and travelling block. Okay, to lift the equipment. Leave it onto the sheaves of the crown block and travelling block. Okay. Its primary purpose is to hoist or lower drill pipe or casing from or into the valve. Into the well. Okay. Next is the monkey board. It is also known as the derrick man's working platform. Okay. The derrick man's working platform. Also known as raking board. If you want the definitions, you can write it from here. Let's go to the next one. The traveling block. Okay. The arrangement of pulley means it will be traveling. The block which is traveling is called traveling block. Okay. Basically, it is attached to the crown block using drilling lines through all its sheaves. Elevators. These are somewhat important. Okay. Actually, these are a set of clamps that grips a stand or a column of casing, tubing or drill pipe. Okay. Basically, the lifting of the equipment. See, once the drilling process is over and we have gone through tripping or tripping out, we have to start the tripping out operation of the drill pipe. Basically, what we will be doing is we will be placing the kelly in the rat hole. Okay, that is the rat hole is the hole which is used to store the kelly. Okay, and we will be attaching the elevators to the traveling block. So, using the elevators, we will be tripping out all the drill pipes into the fingerboard. Okay, we will be going through some videos to show you what elevators are. Okay, firstly know these things. They are clamps that grips a stand of column of casing, tubing, or that is basically tubulars. They are used to catch the tubulars and for lifting them. Okay, the next one is mast. Mast is an equipment that is used in mobile rigs. Okay, for mobile rigs it is called mast. For conventional rigs, it is called derrick. Okay. Doghouse. It is a small enclosure on the rig floor used as an office for the driller or as a storehouse for small objects. Okay. This is the definition of doghouse. Okay. If you can see here, it is present on the rig floor. It is called doghouse and this is called walkways. Okay. If you can see here, this is monkey board. See, next one is pipe ramp. Okay, if you can see here, this is pipe ramp. This is pipe rack. Pipe rack, this is pipe ramp. An angle ramp for dragging the drill pipe up to the drilling platform or bringing pipe down off the drill platform. Okay, as I told you, from pipe ramp, it will go on to the catwalk. From on the catwalk, we will be pulling using a drilling line, we will be dragging the drill pipe to the pipe ramp. From there, it will be placed on the mouse hole. Okay, let me if from the videos you can understand all those things. Okay, but for now try to understand this is the pipe ramp. Next is pipe racks, a horizontal support for tubular goods are called pipe racks. An accumulator, yes, this is good. See, basically the working of blowout preventer is done through hydraulic fluid. Okay, once we the closing to close the blowout preventer, what you have to do is we have to inject some pressure into the blowout preventer. That is done through the accumulator. Basically, accumulator is an storage device for nitrogen pressurized hydraulic fluid. Okay, so accumulator will be attached to the blowout preventer through hydraulic lines. Hydraulic lines. Okay, and the closing of the plates inside the blowout preventer is done through the accumulator only. That is by pressurizing the hydraulic fluid, it will be closed. Okay. Next is cat head. As I already told you, see, this is the draw works and this is the cat head. It rotates. This friction cat head rotates. If you can see here, this is the chain, spinning chain. If you can see, this is the spinning chain. Using this spinning chain and the cat head, we will be make or break the connections. Okay. See, this is the spinning chain. A cat head is this one. Okay. This is the catwalk. This is the catwalk. This is the pipe ramp. This is the pipe ramp. Kelly spinner. Yes, this is somewhat important. See, Kelly spinner is a device which replaces the cat head and spinning chain. Okay. Basically, if I have shown you in the video, right? Basically, it directly makes or breaks the connection without using any chain. Okay. Kelly spinner makes or breaks connection similar to makes or breaks the connection. Okay, breaks the connection, makes the connection, replacing cat head and running chain. Okay, running chain. But for now, first understand this. Okay, we'll be going through one by one. The next one is mouse hole. Mouse hole is the equipment which is used to store the next joint of drill pipe. Okay, shallow bores suspended for later connection of the drill pipe. For next joint of the drill pipe will be placed inside the mouse hole. The next one is rat hole. It is an hole which is used to store the Kelly. It stores Kelly. Stores Kelly in tripping. TRIPPING, tripping out or running in operations. Running in operations. Okay. Okay. The next one is slips. It is a wedge shaped teeth or other gripping elements that are used to prevent the pipe from slipping down. Okay. By placing these slips, we can hold the drill pipe on top of the rotary table. Okay. But is basically slip's main function is to hold the pipe in place. Okay, remember this, the inner diameter of the slips is less than the outer diameter of the drill pipe joint. Okay, drill pipe joint. Next is walkway. Okay, an area created for moving through, personal or protected with handrail. Okay, this is walkways. Okay, let's go through the videos. Okay, we have completed this one. Okay, let's go through the videos. See, right now I will be showing all the videos and all the equipment that is used in the video. Okay, let me show you the adding of drill pipe. Drill pipe connection is over. See, to understand different equipments, you have to know the process. Okay, if you can see here, see right now, see the pointer. This is the next joint of drill pipe that has been placed in the, okay, let's go back. See, next joint of drill pipe that is placed in the mouse hole. And the downhole chain is the spinning chain. Okay, this is the driller's console, which is used to control all the movements of hoisting activities. All those things will be happening from there. Okay, right now they have placed the, wait a minute. Right now, see, a drilling connection. Let us see the equipments that are used in making a drilling rig pipe connection. Okay. See, this is next drill pipe. This is driller's console through which all the operations will be handled. Okay. If you can see here, right now, they are placing the slips. These are placing of the slips to hold the next joint of drill pipe in place. They are using tongs. These are called tongs to break the connection. They are using the tongs to break the connection. Okay, they are using tongs on the rotary table to break the connection. Remember this, they are using tongs and rotary table to break the connection. If you can see here, the downhole part is moving, that is the rotation is due to the rotary table. Okay, yes, right now they are attaching the above Kelly. This is the Kelly. They are attaching it to the next drill pipe that is present inside the mouse hole. If you can see beside here, see the point. Okay, if you can see the point, this is the hoist line. It is attached to the next joint of drill pipe that is present on the pipe ramp. Okay, okay, let's go through the video. If you can see right now, they are connecting the Kelly to the next drill pipe that is present inside the mouse hole. But they are using tongs See, they are using tongs. Okay, they are using tongs. They are using the tongs and they are using the spinning chain and the cat head. Okay, to make the connection, they are using tongs, spinning chain. If you can see, this is the spinning chain to make the connection. Okay, then they are lifting it up. If they are lifting it up, they are lifting it up and they are making the next connection. Okay, this is the spinning chain that is attached to there. Okay, wait, if you can wait a minute, they are making the connection, the next drill pipe with the drill pipe. Okay, if you can wait a minute, see, right now they are making the connection, right? So what they will do is, in the meantime, the drilling activity means the next joint of drill pipe, the next, while continuing the drilling process, what they will do is they remove the slips and the drilling activity continues. Okay, the drilling activity continues. If you can see here, see this particular personnel, this particular drilling personnel, see, this is the hoist line. So using the hoist line, okay, if you wait a minute, yes, the drilling activity is going to start. See, the drilling activity will start once the Kelly reaches the rotary table. Okay, once the Kelly reaches the rotary table. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, see, if you can see here, this personnel is using hoist line, is using hoist line. Wait a minute. See, to bring the next drill pipe, to place the next drill pipe in the mouse hole. Okay, if you can see here, from the pipe ramp, he is bringing the next drill pipe and he will be placing that in the mouse hole. Okay, so during drilling activity, no person will be present on the monkey board. Okay, remember that drilling person will be present on the monkey board only in tripping operations and running in operations. See, right now, using the hoist line, he is bringing the next drill pipe from the pipe ramp and placing the next drill pipe in the mouse hole. Okay, if you can see here, see, okay, yes, he is polishing the joints and he will be placing the drill pipe in the next mouse hole, that is the mouse hole. Okay, let's see another video. Okay, so you can understand all the equipments. Tripping in pipe. Okay, let's see that. See, okay, if you can see here, this is a tripping. Running in is going on here. If you can see here, during the running in operations, a driller will be present. A drilling person will be present on the monkey board. Okay, what he'll be doing is the drill pipes that is present inside the fingerboard will be pushed onto the side from where they will make the connection between the drill pipes and they will be sending it back in. Okay, if you can see here, they are using tongs to make the connection. Okay, and this is the spinning chain. Okay, they are running in the drill pipe inside the wellbore. Just wait a minute. These are the tongs. Okay, it is being running in. Okay, once it has reached it, what they have done is they are placing the slips. Those are the slips. Okay, these are the elevators. These are the elevators. Okay, while in running in condition, these elevators will be going up. Okay, the above personnel, that is the personnel present on the monkey board, will attach the next drill pipe onto the elevators. If you can see here, the drilling personnel is attaching the drill pipe to the elevators and the bottom of the drill pipe will be attached to the next drill pipe. Okay, through the cat head and spinning chain. Okay, this is the process that is involved in running in. Okay, we'll be going through the process again. Right now, I want to give you a figurative idea of how it is going, the equipments that we are using here. Okay. Yes, this is the main process that is involved in running in. Okay. Let's go to the next video. Okay, they will be continuing the activity until all the drill bit reaches the bottom. Okay. Let's go to the next one. Tripping out. Okay, this is very good. In this video, they will be using the Kelly spinner to make or break the connections. Okay, see, right now, yes, this is the traveling block and the red color one is the elevators. Okay, this is the tripping out. We are doing tripping out. They have removed the slips and the elevator catches the drill pipe. Okay, and it pulls to the top of the derrick. Okay, if you can see here, this is the driller's console, which is used to control all the activities in the drilling rig. Okay, if you can see, this is called the driller's console. Driller's console. You can wait a minute. Yes. Okay, if you can see. Okay, wait a minute. Yeah, see, this is a tongue. Okay, this is a tongue. Okay, it is a normal tongue only. Okay, to break the connections, what, see, this equipment, this is called Kelly spinner. Okay, this replaces the running chain and the cat head. This is the Kelly spinner that is used for breaking the connections. Okay, if you can see here, while tripping out, they are placing it in the fingerboard. The bottom part is placed in the here. See, if you can see the up, wait a minute, if you can see on the top, if you can see on the top, if you can see here, see, on the monkey board, a drilling person is present. He will be placing all the drill pipes in the fingerboard. Okay, again the elevator will come down and they will attach the elevator to the drill pipe and the process will be continued. Okay, this is basically the type of equipments. To know the types of equipments, you have to literally see them. Okay, that's why I have made this video. Okay, this is another one. And finally, let me see if there are any good videos so that you can understand that. Let me see the last video to make you understand the different equipments. Okay. Okay, let's see. Yes, see, this is the drilling personnel that he is doing his work in the monkey board. Okay, he is placing them in the fingerboards. Okay, basically this is the work that he is doing here on the top while the pulling out or tripping out is going on. Okay, these are all the equipments that is generally used in oil and gas. Okay, let's go through some of the miscellaneous equipment again. See, basically the equipment that you have to remember means generally these won't be used while steadying. Okay, that you have to remember it separately. Okay, see, crown block, traveling block, all such of equipments will be steadied separately, but you have to know the vocabulary and the terms that are used in oil and gas industry. Okay, such thing as doghouse, that is a room present on the rig floor. Okay, and the second one is cellar, the space that is present below the rig floor to the ground level. And the next one is cat head and spinning chain to make or break the connections. The Kelly spinner, that is also used to make or break the connections. Bell nipple, that is to divert the flow from vertical to the horizontal. Okay, and hoist line to lift the equipment. Okay, if you have seen the other video, it is used to lift the equipment, that is drill pipe, from the pipe ramp to the mouse hole. Okay, hoist line. And let's go to the similar such type of things. Yes, monkey board or racking board, the walkways that connects the rig floor and the ground floor. Yes, doghouse, the mast is used for mobile rigs. The term used for mobile rig, Okay, mast is a term used for mobile rigs. Derrick is a term used for conventional rigs. Okay, and these are some miscellaneous terms that you have to remember. Okay. In the next classes, what we'll do is we will be going through the operating systems. Okay, let me give you a brief idea about that. See, basically, in a drilling rig, there will be six operating systems. Okay, one is well control system, well monitoring system, power system, circulation system, hoisting system. The next one is the circulating system. Yes. Power system. Yes. Yes, those are the things. So we'll be going one by one. Okay, we'll be studying each equipment to the detail in the next classes. Okay, but what we won't be studying is the types of these boats, monkey boats. You have to remember these. Okay, what is a cellar? What are the walkways? These are the terms that you have to remember. Okay, in the next class we will be going through each system separately. Those are the rig operating systems. Okay, yes. And the last thing that I want to tell you is yes. Okay, before seeing the next video, try to complete this chapter, rig components in chapter 2. Okay, go through all the components once again in this particular book. Okay, Heriot Watt chapter 2. Okay, that's it for today's class. In the next video, we will be going through the rig operating systems. It is rig operating systems.